The Panasonic SJ-MJ55 is a slim MDLP player with a semi-slot-in design. As you can see, it comes with a portable speaker dock for tabletop listening and charging. Here, you can see how they made a slot-in design without a large case like the older Sharps. This one isn't working with gumsticks, so let's open it up. You can leave that small screw there. A few more screws on top. Move the battery door away and open carefully. It's actually pretty clean inside, especially the negative terminal. We can do a bit of cleaning, but I don't think this is the problem. There is some corrosion on the battery door that should be cleaned. It's not much, but I'll scrape off what I can also. Remember to clean off the vinegar with isopropyl alcohol. At this point, the contacts look pretty clean, so let's test. I'll hold the battery in place, and let's see if we can get power when we put in a disc. Nope, still dead. So the contacts are clean, but we've lost some metal due to corrosion. There's not enough making contact with the battery. If that's correct, then some of this copper tape should help make a better connection. I've just folded some up and will test by putting it between the battery and the door contacts. There you go. So even though the contacts were clean, there wasn't physically enough metal to make a good electrical connection. Let's confirm with one of my favorite old remotes. This backlit remote had a trick sliding door for hold that made the LCD transparent. It's old, small, and doesn't display everything correctly on some newer models, but it's fun. To make it a bit neater, I took a new piece of copper tape and added a small strip. Line up that hold switch, then let's close it up. Just the usual screws. This takes care of the bottom, but I think we should get in and do a quick clean lube also. It might be the first time in 20 years that these devices have been cleaned. Let's start by removing the top lid screws. Be gentle. By now you know that front panel buttons or display means that there's a flex cable there. It's not bad in here, so I'll start with some isopropyl alcohol on the lens and other parts. There's some dust and battery corrosion flakes in here. Again, we just want to make sure they don't fall into the lens or gears. Now, let's clean off the old lube with more alcohol. Once they're clean, we'll need a little white lithium grease on those parts. As usual, I like to park the laser sled at the far side so it can work the lube into the gear shaft when it powers on. Looks okay, no other debris, so let's close it up. This copper piece is just for testing, but we know what the fix is now. We know it's working now, so let's work the mechanism by playing a full disc and using random, or going from the first to last track. The track numbers don't display properly on the left. Again, this is an old remote for some non-MDLP models, but the basics still work. One more look at the copper tape. So there's another way to fix a finicky battery door if you don't have a spare part. These are fun models, and I hope to get some of the newer ones. As always, thanks for watching.